Much different. Running a little late. Then. But we're getting there. Should you really put it there?
Okay.
Try to get through some of the ones you've asked for. Okay.
Mere Gurudev Charanon Pa Sumana Shara. Shakti hai mera.
Ask for this song again from our friend Maduro. It's a nice song we sing again.
I just close my eyes and the words are carried away by the river. Check it, 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 check it
chakireba nita ocho cheke 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 nita ya ire were were. You want to sing it back there at home? How it ends, yeah.
That's how it ended today.
You know, Osho used to say to us, celebrate everything. And I liked the concept, but I didn't really know how to integrate that into my life. If I was feeling, for instance, grief, or if I was feeling heartbroken, or if I was feeling that there's so much injustice in the world, and how can I celebrate that? The word celebration is a very easy word to misunderstand, because it kind of means, oh, let's get drunk and celebrate. And there is a deeper sense of what celebration is, a celebration of life, and in every aspect. And when you can get to a point where you can feel a sense of, see, celebration is gratitude. It's gratitude. We keep coming back to gratitude, because somehow that's the key for all of us in this Buddha field that we've created together. Because it's not that any one of our lives is perfect, apart from me and Deva, of course. No.
Oh, that's horrible.
I know. It's just an English joke. It's just an English joke, you guys. Don't take me seriously, please. So,
can I just check out? Sorry, there's some white spots on top of you, and I don't know why they are.
Oh, yeah.
Do you see that?
Yeah, I see it.
I'm sorry, Instagram, but I don't know what these white spots come
there's
from.
There's a white spot on my beard.
There's a white spot on your screen, you know? I don't know where that, it must be some kind of effect or something that I...
This
but
man,
anyway,
does,
I'll just put it on his beard, and you can't see it. Sorry for that. I don't know where that comes from. That's really weird. Sorry for that. So anyway, what about perfect life?
Just that none of us have really a perfect life, you know, but we do. We have the perfect life, and that's the key to gratitude, and that's the key to celebration. Whatever we're experiencing, have been chosen to be here for those lessons. And if we can live life like that, it's not easy. You have to take it beyond an intellectual concept into a way of feeling, wow, everything that's happened to me has been a gift. I've had to learn some tough lessons, but it brought me to the point, the place that I am now in my life. And that must mean I'm on a journey.
Mm.
And you can look at a journey as something to be fearful of, or as an adventure. And if we look at life as an adventure, instead of something to be scared of what the next thing's going to happen, if we're living life as an adventure, it means that we're in the moment. We're rooted in the moment, and we're watching and looking to see, what is this then? Where am I? What am I doing? And what has brought me here? And how did I get here? That's a Talking Heads song. Mm. But how did I get here? And how can I give thanks for being here? And who do I give thanks to? And that's the key. It's like there is only a formless consciousness that we can give thanks to. We don't know what this consciousness is, what it looks like, what it feels like. We just know it's there and it's here. It's a formless spirit that we are all connected to, and that's the oneness. It's not our opinions about viruses and face masks. It's not that. That's never going to be in a sense of oneness, but our oneness is the connection to the great spirit, the formless spirit that lives in every living being. And today is Bob Dylan's birthday, and now if you're talking about somebody who was a great teacher and didn't want to be, it's Bob Dylan. I know many of you think that he's just an old guy who couldn't sing very good, but Bob Dylan was a whole, and still is, much, much, much more than that to his generation. So without Bob Dylan, I definitely would never have picked up a guitar. But that's actually not true. I would have picked it up when I saw the Beatles. But anyway, we're going to honor Bob Dylan today. And Dave is going to show you how he would sing the Gayatri Mantra.
No.
Okay. This is Bob Dylan singing David's song Yemayasisu.
Yemayasisu.
That's good.
I think that's enough.
You're too high.
Okay. I'm too in tune.
I think you should have done the Gayatri.
No, I don't.
Do you guys too sacrilegious?
Yes.
Okay. How many roads? This is still relevant today, actually. That's either sad or amazing, depending how you look at life. The virus, my friend, is blowing in the wind.
The answer to the virus.
The answer is blowing. How many? What's the first line? Three times. How many roads must a man walk down before you call him a man? Yes, and how many seas must a white dove sail before she sleeps in the sand? And how many times must the cannonballs fly before they're forever banned? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. Yes, and how many years can a mountain exist before it is washed to the sea? Yes, and how many years can some people exist before they're allowed to be free? And how many times can a man turn his head and pretend that it just doesn't see?
answer, my friends, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. Times must a man look up before he sees the sky? And how many ears must one man have before he can hear people cry? And how many deaths will it take till he knows that too many people have died? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing. So my friend is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind.
It's one of those songs, it's a sad song that makes you happy to sing it. There are a few songs like that. They're sad and terrifying. Something like Blowing in the Wind. But it makes you feel good to sing those melodies. Such beautiful. Like the Gayatri. And no, the Gayatri is not either sad or happy. It's just another dimension.
Somebody wrote something yesterday. How could you say this or that? And it's something, you know, we sit here, this is the 70th time we're sitting here with you. And things come out of us just, you know, sometimes. No? They just come out and then they're gone. And they're out, and sometimes they're just off or so, and it's okay.
It's okay, it's okay. You know, we have to be able to be free to make mistakes in our...
Instagram just turned
in
off.
Our sangha. Oh yeah. We have to be free to make mistakes.
Like Instagram just made a mistake.
Because that's how we learn.
I'm so sorry for that white spot. I just don't know what to do about it. But hopefully you can... If you focus on the white spot, I'm sure you get enlightened. Because that's...
It's right under my nose now. Wait.
And now if you just go... Yeah,
yeah, there it is on my nose.
It.
I'll keep it on my nose. Wait.
I can change it. I'm sure it's just a setting somewhere, but I don't want to...
No, don't worry, David. It's really, yeah. It's okay. It's okay.
Okay.
So anyway, we're going to close our eyes now for our meditation. When we meditate, we reach a sense of gratitude. And that gratitude is what supports us in our grief. It doesn't take the grief away. The grief is a deep, deep, as we all know, a deep, deep feeling that engulfs us and encapsulates us in a way. But when we meditate, we can find a place that's beyond grief. And usually we feel grief if a beloved has passed on, but the beloved wants us to reach that place where there is no grief. The beloved who passes on wants us to be happy. So if you're grieving for a beloved, just know that that beloved wants you to be happy, and it wants you to move, he or she wants you to move into a deep place inside yourself where there is no sense of grief. There's just a sense of space, of formless space.
And there's also no sense of separation or loss.
Yeah, that's it. That's true.
It's a human idea of separation. But once we cross over into the spirit world, it's so clear, it's so clear.
So closing our eyes. Taking a deep breath, take a deep breath together, and another deep breath together. Closing our eyes, begin to chant with Deva the mantra Om. If you want to experiment with the sound humming with your lips pursed, closed, that's okay. It's an interesting way to meditate, and it's a good way to feel our voice as it resonates in our body. So if you want to experiment with the sound always with a deep breath. If you don't take the deep breath, you're going to miss a big part of the meditation. So make sure when you take your breath that you're conscious when you take it, and you breathe deeply into your belly, and then you let the sound come and feel it in your body, and then another breath, and together we link arms and hearts and hands across the world in a sacred and precious Gayatri global Sangha that we become. and pull with your voice. Let's just take a moment to finish our meditation again. A namaste to each other across the world.
Mm.
A namaste to our kindred spirits. And
a namaste towards our inner divinity.
Thank you for joining us again, beloveds. Time for Loka Samasta.
Sukhino Bhavantu. namasta soke no bhavantu loka samasta soke no bhavantu loka samasta soke no bhavantu. Namaste.
You know, nothing lasts forever. You know that, don't you? We don't want to be attached to this space, because obviously we cannot do it forever. So we're just at a point now where I'm thinking, wow, 70 days we've been together. We are solidifying our connection. First, we had a nice connection together, but now we've become friends. And it's of course very seductive to think that we can do this forever. Maybe we can. Maybe we can. I don't know. Neither of us know. None of us know. But we do know that nothing lasts forever.
Which is good.
And as George Harrison said,
yeah,
all things must pass. All things must pass away. So let's enjoy the moment while we have it. I'm speaking for myself. So I love to play for you. Thank you.
Thank you for being with us.
Just going to grab that white spot now. Wait a minute. Where is it? Just there. Grab it.
There must be some spirit. There's another two of. Where are they?
Oh, yeah. All right, beloveds. Namaste.
Love you guys. Thank you.